Hey crafty friends, Emily with you today, and I'm so excited to be sharing our newest product, our gift card holder die with a bow. We have this adorable bow we're going to be assembling today, and it comes with a cute gift tag and a square gift card holder, of course. Then on the back, we do have this imaging, which is so helpful in putting together the bow, and I've actually cut this out of my packaging. So I wanted to show you, you can cut this out yourself and then place it just wherever you keep your gift card holder die with a bow. And I have this wonderful magnetic sheet that I just showed last week. And it's so easy to keep all your dies organized, especially when we have smaller ones like this one. So here I'm grabbing an adhesive sheet. This is from Miss Scrapbook Adhesives by 3L. And I'm just putting this on the back of my paper so that I can cut out some of these smaller pieces of my bow die and have like a sticker on the back so it's easy to stick onto my main bow die. So I'm just going to grab all these smaller pieces. These pieces are just meant to add a little bit of dimension onto that bow and to really make it come to life. So here's our main piece. And then I figured, oh, I might as well just cut them all out at the same time. We don't need the adhesive on the actual bow or these larger pieces. I'm going to show you how I like to put those together separately here, but I just wanted to show you how you can use this adhesive sheet for these smaller bits because it does just kind of help with the process of putting them on, and then you don't really have to worry about glue and the paper warping at all. So I'm just going to grab all my dies and run this through my die cutting machine, making sure that those little pieces are on that adhesive sheet. So now here I'm just going to pop my bow out. Of course, we have the little holes in all of our dies, so you can just pop them out nice and easy. And there's our adorable bow. It looks great, but let's add these details. So this die is the rounded die. So these two dies are actually the exact same die, and they go at the top of the bow. And you can see here from our diagram, they are the exact same. So you could, we could have just had one die in there, but I wanted you to be able to cut them out at the same time, instead of having to cut it once and then cut it again. So I'm just going to start with these dies at the top, and these have the little bit of adhesive on the back. So you can see when I flip this over, you'll see there's a little bit of white there. So we're just going to peel this off just like a sticker. These adhesive sheets are great because they're nice and thin, so they don't cause any like sometimes when you run through your die cutting machine and if it's too thick, you'll get those dots on there, and that doesn't happen with these adhesive sheets, which I love, just from the pressure of your die cutting machine, which isn't a big deal, but I just like the sheets because they're nice and skinny, and then they create the sticker, and then you can easily peel it off. And then I'm just placing these at the top, and the pointed part comes down toward the center of the bow. So look at how great. So that just forms a little bit of a shadow. And you can, of course, do some ink blending. So these are the bottom parts of the bow die. And again, the pointed part always kind of goes toward the center. So see where that pointed part's going up toward the center. And these dies are different. So they do have these slanted angles on each side. And of course, those pointed pieces go toward the center, like I was saying. And then we're gonna do the same process with these little ones. Peel off the backing of the adhesive and then just lay them down. And as I was saying before, you could definitely do some ink blending. I've done a lot of bows with glitter and embossing powder and stuff that I'm happy to show you guys as well, that I will show you in other videos. I just wanted to show you the basics of putting this bow die together in just a slower form. So here are the big main pieces of the bow. So this is where you kind of start to see it like come together with these big pieces I really love. And then of course that adorable little center piece. So here's where I like to use a little bit of foam. So these are my thin foam squares from Scrapbook Adhesives by 3L. Oh, and this backing actually has some adhesive on it. So we could have just put the center down like normal, but I like putting a little bit of foam lift on here, and it just adds just a little bit of dimension. And then you can see it just pops a little bit more. It just looks really cool. And with the thin foam squares, these ones just allow just a little bit of lift, so it's not super dramatic like you would see with a normal piece of foam. It's, you know, just a little bit of lift to add just that little bit of differentiation between these smaller dies and the larger dies, just giving you a nice bow cohesive look. I just love this bow die. Oh, look how cute it is. So then this one kind of goes on again, like the points going up that angle is going up. You can kind of, this one's a little bit easier, I think, to place because you can see it on the bow, on the edge there and everything. And you can kind of line it up and then make sure you're centered, make sure it's just kind of lined up the way you want it. And that is it. That's how you assemble your bow. And look how adorable it is. Oh my goodness. Again, you could definitely add some ink blending to this. And then when we adhere it onto our gift card, so here's this one I made. Oof, I put a little foam on the bow so that you can still insert the gift card and then the little tail stick out. So let me show you. So we'll insert the gift card here just like we do with our regular, our original gift card holder die. Look how cute, and those tails stick out. Or you could glue it down flat, but I like doing it that way. I think it's just more fun. So I did the same thing, and this is using our confetti stencil. I added that foam there and also our graduation stamps with some embossing powder. And this bow I made with some velvet paper, so it's super beautiful. It's attracting a little bit of stuff because it's velvet, but if you have any sort of specialty paper, this is such a great die to use it with, and this is going to be so much fun. This is used with embossing powder and glitter paper. Just imagine for Christmas. So just make sure you get yours now, you guys. This is our new gift card holder die with a bow. Thanks for watching.